What is happening, everybody? Welcome back to the Evil Show. I'm gonna put my fucking hat back on because obviously my hair is like fucked up today. I wore a hat and fucked up. Anyway, what's happening, YouTube? What's happening, other forms of social media? There's a lot of things to go over today, man. Like, I don't even know where to start. You know, I'm gonna start doing the thing called, you know, question of the fucking day. And it's where I ask you guys a question, and I hope it'll catch on or whatever, where you guys post your answers or your responses or whatever. I don't care if it's negative, positive, I don't fucking care. I could care less, honestly. I just wanna see the people's views and opinions on different subjects that I talk about. But today's fucking subject is... today's subject is, of course, going to be about relationships and stuff like that. You know, and how to act in relationships. Because I see a lot of couples out there, and it's just something I really want to talk about. So, let's get started, you know. No, it's just like, when it comes to relationships, it's, for me personally, I hate people who cheat in relationships, right? I will not put up with that shit. It used to be I would, because I would do the same shit, but now it's like the tables are turning. I'm older, I'm 22 years old. I feel like I'm too old for that bullshit. I don't got time for that, man. You know, I'm getting older. I'm trying to live life and shit. Well, not live life. Whatever. Fuck it, y'all. You get the gist of what I'm saying, though. But, you know, it's like how certain things are just delicate subjects for me that I don't talk about them much because it's like, it gets to me personally. One thing that I believe to be true, especially when it comes down to relationships and shit, is, you know, why, you know, and cheating's another subject I'm going to tackle today, if I can, if I have enough time in this video. We're already like 2 minutes in, and I'm babbling on about the subjects and what we're going to be talking about. Let's jump on! First topic to tackle was cheating in relationships. I hate, like, if you have to hide shit in a relationship, then you shouldn't be with that person. You know what I'm saying? It's like, I hate cheaters. I hate females that cheat on their dude, and they would never do that. Like, dudes like me would never do that shit. Because I talked about it a little bit in the last video, you know. And I'm going to bring it up again. You know, I have been cheated on multiple times in the past. I say multiple times because, yes, I've been with a lot of females, you know. I'm not saying that in a proud way. I'm just saying it in a way that you look at it from my perspective of why I say it. So basically, it's like, you know, the last relationship I was in, which, let's say, were to change her name for the sake of legal reasons, we're to call this bitch Crayola. Don't fucking judge me, social media. Fuck you. Anybody who's watching is gonna laugh at that. Fuck you. No, we'll call this bitch, I don't know. Trolina. Let's go with that, Trolina. Now, this bitch is an ex-girlfriend of mine. And I know my wife's gonna see this video. She's gonna get mad at me. She's gonna probably whatever. But it's the fact that I gotta talk about it because this bitch, every year. Now, it was about this month when we started dating, like 4 years ago, back in 2011. It was in November. And we broke up on, like, she broke up with me on fucking Christmas. Like, who the fuck does some shit like that, man? That shit was, like, it's not the fact that it hurt me that she left me, broke up with me. It's the fact that she did it on Christmas. What kind of a heartless bastard are ya? You heartless bastard. You fucking fuck you for watching. Fuck you. Fuck that puta. And the voice of George Lopez. Fuck that puta. Fuck. No. Why am I gonna say no legal reasons? This video would never air.
Oh, that's yeah. Poor fella, never seen a video on the air. Oh.
Anyway. Like, if you're gonna, like, I just think you're gonna break up. Couples break up all the time, but don't fucking do it on Christmas or holidays that are supposed to be fucking special! I can't stress that enough because I was heartbroken on Christmas, dude. I'm like, you know, what kind of a heartless, soulless, spineless, classless bitch does some shit? Or nigga, ladies, if you've had your heart broken on Christmas, I feel your pain. It ain't fun. Nobody wants to spend Christmas alone, heartbroken, depressed. Well, I wasn't depressed over the bitch, I was depressed over the fact. You ask me, do I love her? Hell no. Did I? Hell no! But it's the fact that, yes, I've said that word to a lot of the girls I dated in my past. I do say it to my wife because it's true to the fact that I do love her. And she knows that I do. And again, I know she'll be watching this episode for the fact that I'm the best in the world, as I call myself. It's not even that I call myself that, it should be known. Anyway, I know she's watching and, you know, moving on! Anyway, you know, what was I saying? Anyway, I'm getting sidetracked. She broke up with me, and you know, the fact was that she cheated on me too. But in a way, I cheated on her back. And it's just like that one time by Ariana Grande, it's called Break Your Heart Right Back. You know, I think it's called that, Break Your Heart Right Back. I just right there broke her heart right back by finding someone. Now, we're not going to go into detail on that because clearly we don't have that kind of time, we don't have that kind of money to go into that kind of detail about what happened in that relationship. We don't have that kind of money, we don't have that kind of time, we're already 8 minutes in this video. Why I was talking like that, I don't fucking know. But it sucks to be heartbroken on Christmas, man. And this bitch was like, dude, like, beyond my pole. This bitch was, her moves like, that would change. I'm just like, the fuck? You know? And I know a lot of girls are thinking, you know, oh my god, you're sucking ass over breaking her away. Oh my god, you're gonna go to hell. No wonder you've been cheating on. It's not like that, it's not like that at all. Then what is it? It's the fact that, you know, I had to do what I had to do. I don't know what else you expected me to do. Now, I'm happy in my current status. You know, I'm gonna head out there soon. I'm not gonna say where for, again, legal reasons, and I don't need stalkers and shit, you know what I'm saying? Like, I don't know, it's crazy, the thought, because, you know, and how to explain it? There's no way to explain it, really, because me personally, I hate cheaters. because I used to cheat, but now that it's happened to me a few times in my life recently, or not recently, but like in the past years, not 2014 per se, or 2013 per se, but beforehand, you know. I know a lot of you people who are on Facebook, are friends with you on Facebook, they'll probably, I don't know if you're watching that, you know the story. Some of you know the story of what happened and why I say that. Some of you don't. For those who don't, I'll explain it with like this. There was a time where I made decisions that affected people around me and affected the person who I love dearly. And that's all I can say about that. Again, the people who are watching, they know what happened. I've told them in the past what happened. They know the story. And that's all I can go into detail about that. But, I mean, if you're, I said it before, if you're in a happy relationship, don't fucking cheat. Just leave. Don't stick around and then don't be faithful and shit. You're not going to be faithful and you know you don't want to be with that person. Go be single. Or you know, tell them you're not happy. And I told them before, if you can fix your relationship, then fix it. By all means, do what you need to do to fix that relationship. If not, leave. Don't fucking cheat. And me personally, I don't ever want to experience that again. You know what I'm saying? I wouldn't want to go through that again. Because I went through it once and it was heartbreaking and it hurt really bad. Like I said, I took a year off. In the last video, I told you, I took a year off from dating anyone. and like, it holds to be true. Because it's like, I did take a year off. Wasn't because I needed it, it's because I had to. I just wasn't ready to get back into the game. The reason being was, like I said, the people who knew the story in the previous year before that, what happened, why, what I went through, they know. For those at home watching who don't know what I'm talking about, all I can say was it was something that really took a toll on me, both physically and emotionally. I took a year off. I went to Mexico that following year, and you know, I was having fun. I was single. Yes, I'm not gonna lie, I did flirt with a lot of the girls there. I did, you know, talk to a lot of girls, but I didn't date no one. I'm not gonna lie, because the person who I was previously with, I couldn't get them out of my head. I still wanted to be with them, but that's, like I said, I can't go into detail about that. But, you know, loyalty is everything in a relationship, especially for me personally. I want loyalty no matter what, in relationships, in friendships, anything. I want loyalty, in relationships especially, you know. Because loyalty, not only is loyalty everything, it's the core of a relationship. Of any relationship, marriage, whatever. Be loyal to the person you're with. You know what I'm saying? Because I know a lot of you girls out there are not fucking loyal. Chris Brown said it best. These hoes ain't loyal. And y'all ain't loyal. I see y'all prancing around the way y'all prance around. Look at the way you do. I put in the words of Eric Clapton. You know what I mean? You put on your makeup. You brush your long black hair. You dress like a hooker, but not the expensive kind. Eric Clapton didn't say that, but I was paraphrasing. Of course. But, you know, it fucks me up because I'm the person who, in a relationship, the last relationship I was in before I stopped, you know, being a cheater and shit, I was loyal. And some of my relationships, I was loyal 100%. The other person, however, they were not. They decided to go and pursue someone else while they were with me. So it's like, couldn't stop, I had to move on. But regardless, loyalty is just everything. When you're loyal, that's, I have respect for you. To the girls especially, if you're loyal to your man and you're doing everything right, you know, hats off to you. You know, my hat's off to you. To any of the dudes out there too, this is for y'all. Like, not in a gay way, but I'm saying man to man. If you're in a relationship and you're being loyal to your chick, wife, girlfriend, fiance, whatever the hell, I don't know your guys' relationship status, whatever the hell you are. If you're loyal to them, hats off to you, because you don't see that anymore. Because nowadays it's all about going to the club and going out to parties, getting drunk, doing this and that. You know, I'm not, personally, I don't do that shit anymore. I do drink here and there. I don't smoke. I'm not going to say if I do or don't for legal reasons. But, you know, I stopped doing that shit a long time ago. And it's like, I don't get it. I don't get why some of you do what you do when you're cheap and you're not loyal. You're honesty is another thing. Honesty is another thing. Honesty in a relationship, it's like if you're in a relationship, be honest with your significant other about where you're going, who you're with, or how you feel, why you're angry, why you're this, why you're A, why you're B, why you're X, Y, Z, why you're 1, 2, 3, etc., etc. You get the point. It's not hard to do. Honesty goes a long way, especially to those who know me. Honesty goes a long way. When you're honest to me, I can trust you. And my trust is something, once you break it, you're done. You're cut off. If you betray me and you break my trust, you destroy that wall, you destroy that bridge, you burn it. Whatever metaphorical analogy that you want to use. Once it's gone, it's gone. You don't get another chance. I've stopped talking to so many people from high school for that reason, because they just weren't who I thought they would be. It's sad to say, but sometimes it's life. You gotta lose people in order to gain new people. Those who have stuck around in my life, you all know who you are. Those people that I talk to, you know who you are. I don't even address your name. You should know who you are. To anyone that stays on to watch these videos, I applaud you and I thank you. I appreciate you. To those who don't, well, you're lost. I can't force you to stay and watch my videos. But I think I can give you some good advice. But honestly, especially relationships, marriages, you know, honesty means the world. It really does go a long way in the long run. It goes a long way, you know. And when you're honest, that just shows that you're serious. And for me especially, in relationships, all I want is honesty, loyalty, the truth. How hard is it to tell your partner, your significant other, your husband, wife, boyfriend, girlfriend, your fiance, whatever the fuck. And I'm not aiming this at nobody, so I don't want nobody to think I'm aiming this at them. I'm just talking out of experience, out of personal experience, a little bit, from stuff that I've gone through. And it's like, you know, It's not hard to do. You shouldn't have to lie to your significant other about who you're going to be with. I had an ex who was like that. She knows who she is. We no longer speak. For that reason, we no longer speak. For the fact that every time when we were together, that I was one more. I was making more of the effort to try to see her. And I started talking to some of her friends, and I found out a lot of things that I didn't like. I found out a lot of things that, you know, I wasn't okay with it. I wasn't okay with the fact that she was talking to these guys and they were flirting with her and shit like that. The only, and my wife, fiance, whatever, you know, there was a day, and I probably shouldn't say this, but I know she wanted my Facebook information. And yes, I do have Facebook. How else would I fucking promote this shit? What else would I do for YouTube? I do random shit from time to time. I apologize. But she wanted my Facebook shit. And it's not that I don't trust her with it. It's just that I don't really do that anymore. I learned my lesson many relationships ago. It's nothing towards her. It's not that I don't trust her. I don't respect her. It's that I just don't. I don't get it. I just don't do that. You know, it's like, again, it's not that I don't trust her or whatever. I just don't do that anymore. I don't give my information out like that to nobody. And even my friends, I don't let nobody hack my shit. And my shit's secure. The only time I've done it was with one ex-girlfriend, who I do still talk to, but strictly as friends, because she's engaged too. And her name, which I'm going to change for legal reasons, is Becky. Now, me and Becky have a different history than most of the girls I was with. You see, I went through a lot of heartbreaks, a lot of ups and downs with Becky. You know, when we were together, we dated many years ago, back in 09. This was 09, by the way, because I know somebody's in season 10, like, oh, I don't know. Did you know he was talking about one of his exes on the videos? Did you know? Sure, she doesn't care. I'm with her now. That's all that matters. But with my wife, of course, not Becky. But we went through a different kind of relationship than most of the chicks I was with. You know, she was like the only one who actually had access to my Facebook at one point. And I had access to hers too, because we went through so much together, you know what I'm saying? It's like, I forgot what I was gonna say. Also, to MySpace, I used to let her go on my MySpace. And I'm not going to more subject, but you know, like I was saying, honesty is everything. When you're not honest in a relationship, that kills so much trust. And I'm the jealous type too, and I get pissed easily. You can ask my wife. You can ask my fiance, wife, whatever. I call her my wife. You can ask her. You know? To my friends that are on Facebook, they're going to see this. You can ask her, hey, is it true that Jose is the jealous guy? The jealous type? Yes, I man up to me. I do get jealous. I do get overprotective. I do say things that I don't mean to say sometimes. But I do it from a place of caring. We're already 24 minutes into this fucking video. This is going to be a long video. This is longer than most of the videos I've ever done. You know, fuck the same. I don't remember what I was saying. Fuck, what was I saying? don't know, man, but it's just crazy because the reason I wanted to bring this up was because I don't want anybody to go through what I went through back a couple of years ago. Now, I'm not saying my relationship is perfect. No relationship is. No couple is. All couples have fights. All, you know, it's just something that happens. There's no control. You don't control it. It just happens. So, like, you know, I don't know what else to tell you about that. Honestly, I just think it's saying a lot about your character, too, though. Because I've had a lot of shit happen to me in the past in my relationships that kind of fucked me up now. Especially considering what I'm about to do next month. But it kind of fucks me up in the long run because it's from so many times. It's hard for me to like believe things because when it comes to my wife, it's not that I don't want to believe things she says. Because I do. And I do believe her everything. And sometimes there's those times where it's from the past, it got me so fucked up and it's hard for me to completely 100, 200% trust some stuff. I can't trust other guys because I've been cheated on and left for other guys so many fucking times that it's fucked me up both mentally and not emotionally, but it's like it fucked me up pretty good. So it gets hard. But we're already 26 minutes in. So, I mean, I don't really know what else to say, though. Because there's not much else to say. So, I mean, with that being said and all that information being put out there, there's a lot more I can tackle. I can say more about that, but it's gonna be too long of a video. So maybe later in an hour, maybe I'll see in an hour how I feel. And if I'm up to it, I'll make another episode. But for right now, this is gonna be it. This is gonna be me signing off. Subscribe, comment, like, share. Or fucking no, I don't care. I will see you guys later. Peace.